Skill building.
For about 5 years now, one of the teachers at Beatty Elementary, he actually comes, teaches my after-school program staff how to create rockets. And they are water-propelled rockets. So what they do is they build these rockets, and then we have a launch day where all the schools are shipped with buses and going bus to one school site, and they actually compete against one another. So every school is really jazzed about it. They have they make them out of smart water bottles or 2-liter bottles, but that's a collaboration project that we've been going on for 5 years now.
We've incorporated dance and we've incorporated percussion. And so our percussion is a tribal drum class that students participate in once a week. They learn an array of instruments. So it's not just one instrument. They become masters of each instrument in the drum circle, and it culminates with an actual performance in front of the entire school that gets pushed into our performing arts showcase.
We're working on an endangered species art contest. The students get to work on it throughout the month of March. So it allows them to perfect their art and also master their skills.
Kids learn to be kind to others, make sure that everyone's included. So our leadership program, the children, there's cards that they have, like socialization cards and questions for the kids. And so when they teach the younger children how to talk to each other, how to socialize with each other, how to make sure everyone's included, when it comes from a peer, it's a lot more meaningful to them because it's not an adult telling them, it's a peer, an older peer that they look up to.
If someone's eating alone by themselves, go over there and cheer them up and just try not to make them feel alone, like they're left out every time. Go sit next to them, try to cheer them up. And my role is try to make them feel good. Try to make them like they belong here, one of the three rules: work, respect, and belong.
Ever since I started the program, I found photography interesting. I know that photography was a work in progress because not everything is perfect in the first time. As time goes on, photography has been getting easier and easier, but there's still so much to learn.
All the activities we do are not only like one-time things, it's repetitive and more like you do this one day, you learn it, and then you keep going so that you build the skill and learn it more and get comfortable with it, so that if you're presented with a project or something that you need to use those skills, like, oh yeah, I can do this. I learned this at the Youth Institute, you know? I have to make a lot of movies in school, so they're like, oh, who knows how to edit? Who knows how to use a camera? Who knows how to like make something on Photoshop? Like, oh yeah, I know how to do that. And they're like, what? Like, that's cool, because, you know, they're my age, they're my grade, but they're not exposed to the kind of things that I am.
Having photography one of my best or like favorite hobbies to do, I will want to get good at it because it's something that I like or something I am interested in. So having the chance to come here and always have the opportunity to have the equipment there when I want it is good. Every time I go out on a photo shoot, every time I go out to do a job, I learn something new every time.
Through the implementation of the skill building standard, students participate in activities that help them achieve mastery of 21st century skills. The quality standards are a guide to help you lead your program to its highest quality. Your work in expanded learning is essential to helping young people thrive.